In last video, we discussed the concept of relational data model. Now, in this video, we will discuss concept of the relational key. Field of the relation which uniquely identifies the record in a table or relation is called relational key. We are having the different keys are available, different types of the keys. First one, we are having the super key, candidate key, primary key, composite key, foreign key, and alternate key. Very first one, we are having the super key. What is a super key? Attribute or set of attribute that are used to identify record uniquely. Let me say, here we are having one record attribute, that is a roll number that is used to identify the record uniquely. That is called super key. The combination of attribute. So what is the super key? Roll number is the super key. First one, we see that we are having the roll number is a super key. That is attribute that is used to identify the record uniquely. Now, any combination of attribute with the super key is also a super key. Let me see that roll number is a super key that is used to identify the record uniquely. Now, any combination with the roll number, combination can be here roll number and name, that is also a super key. Roll number, name and address, roll number and year, roll number, name and year. So all of these are called super key. Why? Because we see the combination of attribute with a super key is also a super key. So here roll number is a unique identified record. Value is not repeated, that can uniquely identify the record, that is a super key. So combination of roll number with other attribute like name, address, that is also a super key. Next one, we are having the candidate key. The candidate key is a super key that doesn't contain extra attributes. It might have more than one attribute to identify the record uniquely. So what we say, the candidate key that doesn't contain the extra attribute, that in previous example, if we see that roll number and name is a super key. Here we say for the candidate key, we see that the super key that is used to identify the record uniquely. We are having one or more than one record can be there, but that doesn't contain the extra attributes. So roll number is a, here in this one example, roll number is a candidate key that is used to identify the record uniquely. So roll number is a candidate key, but it doesn't contain the extra attribute. It, combination of roll number and name, that can be a super key, but that is not a candidate key. Every candidate key is a super key, but every super key is not a candidate key. What we say? Every candidate key is a super key, but every super key is not a candidate key. Why? In every super key, it may be possible that we are having the some extra attribute with a super key. That is also a super key, but extra attribute are not allowed in a candidate key. Candidate key must follow two main properties. First one, we are having the uniqueness property. In uniqueness properties, the key uniquely identifies the tuple of the relation. The key uniquely identifies the tuple of the relation. And second one, irreducibility. No proper subset of the candidate key can uniquely identify the record. no proper subset has the uniqueness property. That's why we see that subset of the candidate key can't uniquely identify the recurse. Here, roll number is a candidate key that can uniquely identify the record. If we check in this one relation branch number, that can uniquely identify the record. Postal code, that can also uniquely identify the record. So in relation, we may have more than one candidate key. Whenever we are having one candidate key or more than one candidate key, but extra attributes are not used over here, and both of these must follow, every candidate key must follow the two main property, uniqueness and irreducibility. Now next type of the key, that is the primary key, attribute or group of attributes, set of attributes that uniquely identify the record in a relation or table. Primary key is a candidate key that is selected to identify the tuple uniquely within the relation. In practical implementation, we are using the concept of the primary key. We see that when we are having any relation is there, in that one relation, we must have to assign the primary key as the main property, one of the properties of the relation. Each row must be unique. For uniqueness of the row, we have to assign the primary key. So the value of the primary key can never be null. How we can represent it? The value of the primary key can be represented by underline the attribute name or column name. That branch is an attribute, is a relation. Branch number is used for unique identification of the record. So branch number is a primary key. That is a candidate key. We may have more than one candidate key. We have to select one of them as a primary key. So branch number is a primary key. Underline it. Attribute, underlining the attribute by a solid line. Now other attributes are the street, city and postal code. Here in the student, primary key is roll number, is a primary key that is used for the unique identification of the record. So the value of the primary key can never be repeated. At S01, that is the roll number. So no one else has the same roll number. S09, no one else have the same S09. So value of the primary key must be unique. The value of primary key can never be null. So whenever we are assigning the primary key, it must have the two main properties. First one, uniqueness. Two main constraints are automatically implemented. First one, we are having the unique constraint, and second one, not null, that we must have a value. Its value can never be null. In this one relation, branch relation, branch number, we say that underline it, so it means branch number is a primary key that is used to uniquely identify the record in a relation. Although in this one relation we are having another key, that is a postcode. Now next concept, that we are having the composite key. The primary key that consists of more than one attribute in a relation is called composite key. When one attribute may not be able to identify the record uniquely, in that case we have to use the composite key. When single attribute is unable to uniquely identify the record, then two attributes are used. Let here we are having table student, student number, name, class and subject. let me draw the table over here. What we have, table is here, student. We have to draw a few rows. For the relation, we must have to follow some relation property. Roll number, names, date of birth and subjects. Okay, what we are having, relation name is here, student. Now we are having few attributes are there, roll number, next one we are having the name, next one we are having the address, and last one we are having the subject. Let's hear in student number. Student roll number is 1. Name we said at Ali. Address we are using street number 1. Okay, and this one student is enrolled with the different subjects. Like this one student is enrolled with the subject of DLD. Same for this one student, we are having another subject. We said at database. Right, so same student is there, but having the different values. So what, how we can use it over here? We can't use the multi value, so for that one we have to repeat the same value over here. We have to use the same value only, and street address 1, and but subject is different. For we see that another student, we are having the roll number 2, name is here Ahmed. And we are having the address is here ABC, and subject can be, we are having the database, or similarly for the same student we are having another subjects, that is the programming, and all the other values are the same. So I'm just using this one. This one is here, Ahmed and ABC. Now if we check it over here, vision attribute is used to uniquely identify the record. Roll number, we see that the value can never be repeated. Here in roll number 1 and 1, the value are the repeated, same value is repeated twice. So whenever value is repeated, so it means the roll number may not be able to uniquely identify the record. 2 and 2 is repeated. Name values are repeated, Ali and Ali. Street 1, address values are repeated. Subject values are also repeated over here. Database and database. So no single attribute may be able to uniquely identify the record. When single attribute is unable to uniquely identify the record, then we have to use the concept of the composite key. Now we have to use the two different attributes that can uniquely identify the record in our relation. So that is the composite key. What are those attributes? Let's check. Roll number and name, 1 Ali. Then now combination of both of these are also repeated. 1 Ali and 1 Ali, both of these are repeated. Address, roll number an address. Again, repeat it. Now, name address. Again, repeat it. Now, we are having the option is here, combination of the roll number and subject. That can uniquely identify. Combination of roll number 1 and DLT. 1 and database. 1 is repeated total, but combination of both of these can never be repeated. 1 DLT. We may not have a same value again. So, whenever we are having one attribute, may not be able to uniquely identify the record in a relation. So, we have to use the concept of the composite key that is used to uniquely identify the record. So, we are here, we are having the roll number and subject is a composite key that is used to uniquely identify the record. No single attribute uniquely identify record. So, here we are having the composite key. So, what is the composite key? So, composite key is here. And we are having the two different attributes and the relation roll number and subject. That is a composite attribute that is used for the unique identification of the record in a relation. Now, another type of the key, that is the alternate key. As we say, the concept of the candidate key, that we may have more than one candidate key in a relation. The candidate key, if we are having more than one candidate key, one of the candidate key we have to select as a primary key. Let here we are having branch relation, in branch relation we are in branch numbers is a candidate key, as well as postal code is a candidate key. We have to select one as a primary key. So branch number is a primary key. So the candidate key that is not selected as a primary key, that candidate key is called alternate key. So here postal code is also a candidate key, but this one is not selected here as a primary key. Remember that one. And relation, we must have only one and only one primary key. More than one primary key are not allowed in a relation. We may have the composite key, but one primary key. So here, postal code is a candidate key that can uniquely identify the record in a relation. So the candidate key that is not selected as a primary key, so this one is called the alternate key. So postcode is a alternate key. So in primary key, postcode is a alternate key. Now another concept, we are having the foreign key. Attribute of group of attribute in a relation that serve as a primary key of an other relation in the same database. That we are having the same database is available within the same database. Attribute in a relation that serve as a primary key in any other relation. Attribute of one table, that attribute of table B, that is a primary key in the table A. So attribute in the table B is called foreign key. The value of foreign key can be null. Let we are having two different relations. One is branch, that having the branch number, street, city and postcode. Second one, we are having the staff. And staff number, first name, last name, position, sex, date of birth, salary and branch number. So branch number is an attribute. Here we are using the branch number attribute in staff relation, which is used as a primary key in a branch relation. So attribute of one relation which is used as a primary key in any other relation, that attribute is called foreign key. The value of the foreign key must match with the parent key value, with the primary key value. So when we say that branch number is here, so we may have the value in the branch number that must be matched with this one branch number value that is available in the branch table, or its value can be null. So when we say that we are having the foreign key to create the relationship among the different relation, we are using the concept of the foreign key. Value of the foreign key can be null, or the value of the foreign key must match with the parent key value. Let here we are having the two relation. One is a branch, branch number, street, city, postcode. Second one staff, staff number, first name, last name. And here we are having the branch numbers. So branch number is a foreign key. The value of the foreign key must match with the parent key value. This one branch number, which is used as a primary key in the branch table. Thus, we say that the foreign key is used to create the relationship among the different table. How we can take another example? To discuss the concept of the foreign key, we see that we are having the one table is here, employee table. In employee table, we are having the different attributes are there. I'm not writing all the attributes, I'm just taking the example from the HR schema in Oracle. So we see that employee ID. First name, last name. We are having first name. Then last names. Her date. I am using last name attribute. We are having the debt ID, department ID. Now in other relation I am creating it over here, in which we are having the attribute department ID. Another attribute department names. If we check in this one table, employee ID is considered as the primary key. So underline it. In this one table, department ID is the primary key. The value of the employee ID must be unique. The value of department ID must be unique. But when we see that we are having the attribute here, that is the department ID. This one attribute is used for unique, this one use attribute in employee table, which is used as a foreign key in any other table. Which one table? We see that department ID attribute in employee table, which is used as a primary key in department table. So department ID in employee table is considered as a foreign key. The value of the foreign key can be repeated. When we say that primary key, value must be unique. For the foreign key, we may have the same value, repeated value. Right? Its value can be null. But if we have a value in the foreign key column, the value must match with the parent key value. If you are using the value here in the department ID, so all of those value must be matched with the department ID in the department table. That is the basic concept of the foreign key. And foreign key is used to create the relationship. In database, Based on these foreign key, we may be able to create the giant to retrieve the data from different tables. Thanks for watching the video.